Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to London, England, here back at the finals hall at the Royal Artillery Barracks for today's event, 25 This World Cup has had great attendance of over 800 athletes representing 96 countries who have traveled great lengths to experience the enormous venue here. There are those who will be using this time as a warm-up for the London Games, trying out the newly installed ranges for rifle, pistol, and shotgun in the upcoming days. More likely than not, getting used to the finals hall and shotgun range with the excitement of the Olympics right around the corner. But for now, the focus is on our silver, gold, silver, bronze medals. The podium is now patiently waiting to be stood on by three talented shooters. Who will they be? Once the competition ends, all will know. I'm Hilary Russell, and I have the pleasure of having my dear friend, Serbia's 2010 World Championship silver medalist, Zorana Aranovic, here with us today. Thanks so much for joining us today, Zorana.
Thank you for inviting me again.
I'm sorry about qualifications today. I know. But, you know, we do have these eight finalists in, and it's going to be very interesting. We were talking earlier today, Kim, who has 592 points over Maruskova, who has 588. We were kind of wondering if that's already a done deal for the gold. But let me introduce our finalists right now, and then we can talk a little bit about that. And Zorana, you can stop dancing in your seat right now. Sorry. And in eighth place, coming with 583 points, represented the Republic of Korea, we have La Young Chung. She's 26 years old, and she won the bronze medal in Shangwon in 2005 during the World Cup there. And in seventh place today, coming with 584 points, representing the People's Republic of China, we have Chen Ying. She's 34 years old. She won the gold medal during the Olympic Games in Beijing in 2008. She also was a world champion in Zagreb in 2006 and also won the bronze medal in 2002 during the World Championships. She's a three-time World Cup final gold medalist and a nine-time World Cup gold medalist. And in sixth place, coming with 585 points representing Bulgaria, we have Antoinetta Bonova. She's 26 years old and she's a three-time World Cup bronze medalist.
We have Antoinetta Bonova.
In fifth place, coming with 585 points, representing Germany, we have Munkbayar Dorscherin. She's 42 years old. She won the bronze medal during the Olympic Games in Beijing in 2008. She also was the world champion in 2002, and she won the gold medal during the World Cup final in 2008, as well as being a five-time World Cup gold medalist. And in fourth place, coming with 586 points, representing Serbia, we have Jasna Šurekarić. She's 46 years old. She won the bronze medal during the Olympic Games in 1988. She also is a two-time World Cup gold, World Cup final gold medalist, and a 16-time World Cup gold medalist. And in third place, coming in with 586 points representing France, we have Céline Gauberville. She's 25 years old. She won the bronze medal during the World Cup final in Munich in 2010. She also won the silver medal during the World Cup in Belgrade in 2010. And in second place, coming with 588 points, representing the Czech Republic, we have Lenka Maruskova. She's 27 years old. She won the silver medal during the Olympic Games in 2004. She also won the bronze medal during the World Championships in 2010, and a one-time World Cup final gold medalist, as well as other great awards. Then in first place, with 592 points, representing the Republic of Korea, we have Chang Mi Kim. She placed 13th in Munich in 2010. And that's all she's got. And yes. She's in first, and she's got a big lead.
Pretty impressive result in here.
So, all right, during the 25, no. What am I talking about? During the last pistol event that we had for women,
yes,
we had three of the same finalists.
Yes, it was Maruskova, Celine, and Bonela.
Yes, and so they made it into another final this week. Very exciting for them. What are you kind of thinking about this Kim with
Well, you know what? The result she has is really impressive. And she has, in this moment, she has really big advantage over Maruškova. So I am not sure that Maruškova will be able to catch up and to maybe even make some advantage over Kim, because 4 points is a lot, you know?
It's 5 points, actually.
Five. No, it's 4 points.
Oh, sorry.
88 and 92. But also, you know, Maruškova can shoot really good finals. So I don't know.
Yeah.
I think that Kim has big advantage, but I wouldn't be surprised if Maruškova would catch up and maybe even be on the first place after the final.
That would be a real
real treat for all of us who are watching this.
And, you know, all during this week, it's been like that, it's been down to, you know, last series or the last shot.
Yes.
And the scoreboard has just been upset over and over and over again. So anything can happen. And, you know, Maruškova, she's been shooting really, really well, and we'll see.
Yes, she's very good in both disciplines. And you have three girls here who are very talented and in this point very good in both disciplines. So we'll see who will be today on the podium.
Let's talk about Bonova just for a second here. You're a good friend of hers.
Yes.
And she's really doing very well in the last few years.
Yes.
You know, she's really gotten right back on track, and you know, it's good to see her in a final again.
Yes.
And of course, let's talk about your teammate.
Yes. My teammate. I'm really happy for her because she has some problems in shooting for the last couple of competitions, let's say so. So I'm really happy that she got back on the track. And I'm happy that I have someone who's shooting that good who can help me, of course, to improve. She has been a great support for me in many, many competitions, and she's the one who at first taught me how to shoot rapid fire, then I forgot. But now I'm trying to get that back again.
You really broke my heart, but made me laugh today when we were talking during qualifications, and you said that you were having some problems. I said, well, what exactly is the problem that you're coming up against? And you said, shooting.
Yes, shooting is my problem at the moment.
You're gonna get it back. I know you are.
Yeah, I know. It's not a problem, but like many other athletes, no matter what sports you are in, you're facing difficulties, and sometimes you're just working, and you just can't get over that. So until some point when something basically happens, something snaps, and you're back on the track. So
right.
I'm waiting for that moment, and hopefully I will get it before Olympic Games.
You certainly will. I know it. I'm going to good vibe you all the way to the Olympic Games.
Oh, wonderful.
All right.
Wonderful.
Okay, so it looks like we're going to get this started.
So now should we talk while they're shooting?
Of course. I don't know if anyone's going to hear us, but we can talk anyways. There's Dor Schuren.
Well, it used to be that.
Starting off perfectly at 10.5, 10.5, now at 9.9.
But look at Kim. 10.8, 10.3, 10.1.
Dear Lord.
Looks like it's going to be a good one.
Chen also 10.4, 10.3, 0.1, 0.5.
Wonderful. Everything looking good for my teammate.
This is good.
Yes.
After series one, where Kim shot a total of 51. That's a really, really good series for Kim. Maruškova at 48.2. Gobavia 51.6. Sekarik 52.3. That's huge.
Yes, that's wonderful.
Dorsen a 51.6. Bonova 52. Excellent work also, Bonova. Chen a 51.5. And La 49.9.
Oh, I didn't see Maruškova's screen, but it looks to me that she had some low shots. She had couple of nines and low nines.
Yes.
Oh,
So let's just take a look now. We have Kim, of course, still holding on to first place. Now she's got 7/10 more of an advantage over Sekarich, who has moved up into second place. Let's see here. Behind her, we've got Robert V. She's 6/10 behind Sekarich. And, you know, Kim, 4.7.
That's a big advantage, but you see that from starting with Goberville to Chen, it's 0 point something. So
exactly,
it can all change in one series, and I have three more series to go. So, I don't know. This is so exciting for us who are standing behind the screen.
That's right. The one standing behind the sport pistol, it might be a different feeling there.
Oh yes. No. Yes, it's actually quite hard and even a bit frustrating, because at that point heart rate is really high. You know, the heart is beating fast. My hands, I can speak for myself. Hands are shaking.
Yeah.
Basically, you can forget everything you have to do. You can.
Really?
Yes.
That's not a good thing, Zorana. No.
No. That's why I think that the biggest results have those who keep their concentration on high level.
Let's take a look now on Bonova.
For me, it's surprising that she's aiming with her left eye. You know, she's a right-handed shooter, but she's aiming with her left eye.
And why do you suppose that is?
I have no idea, and I never... And I will ask.
Starting off the 9.5. On now to Sherridge. Maruskova, nice shoot.
She looks very steady.
She certainly
you
does.
Know, she has smooth movements of her pistol. She's not nervous.
Cam
at least
with a
she
10.9.
Look
that. Amazing. Now 9.8.
And she's very serious.
She certainly is. We have Kim, who has shot 51.0. Maruskova, a 51.2. Gober V, a 50.1. Sekarich, a 46.8. Dorsarin, a 50.9. Bonova, a 50.7. Chen, a 50.0. And La, a 49.8. Let's take a look at the standings. Kim is just gone way above the others now. She's ahead by 6.3 tenths of a point above Bonova, who has now moved into second place, tied up with Gobervi. Dorsarin is now in fourth place, but only 2 tenths of a point behind the tie for second. Maruskova, only 1 tenth of a point now behind Dorsarin.
And look, Bonova from sixth place, I know, to second place. And what Jasna had, that is that concentration I was talking about. So at one point, if you lose it, you simply forget everything you have to do. And this is the thing that happens usually, because rapid fire stage is a stage where you have to be, your mind actually has to be blank.
Yeah.
You know, you are supposed to be not thinking about anything or just to focus to one thing. If you lose that, always something like this happens. You have shots that are not close to 10 or not 10 or not close to 10 at all. So as you can see, Jasna had, if I'm not wrong, 7.7. This is a big major mistake that happens when you're not focused on what you're supposed to do.
Do you think it is perhaps from the excitement of having shot 52 point something, you know, such a great score like that, excited?
No. Yes, it can be exciting for us younger shooters, but for her, she has so much experience. So she's so experienced shooter that I think it's just that she wasn't focused enough. But I think this will be a good series.
Yeah, I think so too. I think she's going to get right back into it.
Well, at least I hope.
Dorsarin starting off with a 10.0. Now on to Gober V, who is tied up for second right now.
And look, she's also very calm. You can see that by the top of the pistol when she fires. It's not, it doesn't have big.
Bonova, who wants to hold on to that second place, has shot an 8.6.
And the biggest thing in rapid fire stage is that you can see when you make a mistake, but the point is not to remember your mistake. You have five shots in series. Mistake on the first shot, then you have to try to do the rest four shots normally so you can have a good score. If you tie to your first shot that is not good, then your whole series won't be good.
Let's take a look now. Kim with a 50.9. This is after the series three. Maruskova, a 51.3. Gobavi, a 52.2.
Wonderful.
Yes, really good. Sharovich, 51.1. Dorsarin, a 49.9. Bonova, a 49.8. Chen, a 50.7. And La, a 51.6. Kim has lost some of her lead there, but she's still up by 5 points. Gobavi has now taken over second place by herself. And behind her, we have Maruskova, who is 1.2 tenths of a point behind. Bonova has moved down into fourth place, and she is also 1.2 tenths of a point behind Maruskova. Dorsarin is only 1 tenth of a point behind. Okay, so we've got one more series, Zorana. What do you think?
I have no idea, because
obviously,
like in the air pistol final, everything comes down to the last series. You know, you saw that you can slip, mm-hmm. and you can have a bad series, but you also saw that you can come back right after bad series. So, both of them, Celine and Lenka, had their bad series. They came back to normal again, but who knows?
Okay.
Really, I wouldn't dare to say who will be second place and who will be third, because obviously Kim has great advantage that is not achievable anymore.
No.
But I have to say, I really have to say that my biggest congratulations to all women who entered the final, because the conditions for shooting were really hard. We were shooting in a very extremely low temperature in the open range, with wind blowing straight to your face, and with all kinds of sounds because of the marathon today, of the helicopters and everything.
A lot of distractions.
Yes, yeah. Just a lot of distractions, and really big congratulations to all women who adapted to this, well, I can say not so good conditions for shooting, actually very bad conditions concerning weather.
Let's take a look now at Bonova.
She's under stress.
Yes. Gobavi seems very at ease.
Yes. Relaxed.
Yes. She seems to have gotten extremely strong in the last 2 years. She
yes.
seemed very timid in 2009 yes. or 2010.
I think it was 2010.
And now she seems like she's really grown into her own, which is good.
She just had a breakthrough. She just started entering all the finals and winning medals in World Cups. So for her, I think this will be a very good season.
There's our gold medalist, who can already say that.
I think Gobreville, second place, Marushko,
so.
Third place.
Let's see, you are yeah. right, Gobreville in second place.
Oh, with final world record.
Excellent work by Kim Jang, Jangmi Kim from the Republic of Korea. A new final world record.
Wonderful.
Unbelievable shooting. And there she is, our gold medalist.
Are we going to see a smile?
Let's see. I hope so. Goodness.
Come on, smile. The gold medalist. We are waiting. And here it is, a little smile. Oh, wonderful.
Nice. That is nice. Jangmi Kim.
That is world record smile.
Yes, the final world record smile. Excellent work there. And let's take a look. Here she is, our silver medalist, Celine Gobavi from France.
I am really
excellent
happy
shooting,
because
yeah.
she didn't win medal in air pistol, so I'm really, really happy for her.
And there's our bronze medalist today, Lenka Maruskova. She won the bronze and
yes,
she just
in
the day,
pistol.
In air pistol. Excellent. She's starting off the season right on the right foot. Zorana, I wish you a very safe trip back to Serbia, and I just want to say thank you so very, very much for joining us today.
Thank you.
And Nothing. The best of luck.
Thank you.
Presented by Susan Abbott, Chairman of ISSF Pistol Committee and Chairman of the ISSF World Cup Pistol Jury. The bronze medalist, representing the Czech Republic, Lenka Maruskova. The silver medalist, representing France, Céline Gobeville. Gold medalist representing Republic of Korea is the new world record holder, Kim Yang Mi. Ladies and gentlemen, please rise for the national anthem of the Republic of Korea. Ladies and gentlemen, please acknowledge all our women's 25-meter pistol medalists.